If you've edited on Premiere Pro, you understand how time-consuming it can be to do some basic edits like text animations, graphics, etc. That's why I recommend these three plugins for Premiere Pro so you can save hours of editing time. That way you can focus on actually being creative in the edit and not just adjusting keyframes. The first plugin is absolutely free, and while the other two are paid, they're totally worth it, and the last one is actually my favorite. So with that, let's get started. Okay, so the first plugin I want to talk about here is Premiere Composer by Mr. Horse. So I have the Premiere Composer plugin installed here on the right-hand side. And when you open it, you'll see I only have the free edition. There is a paid version of this, but the free one is fantastic and I still use it all the time. All right, so let's see what's included in the starter pack. You'll see here that you have a bunch of text presets and boxes, and then you have transitions, a few things you can use for social media icons and animated banners and things like that, some shapes, and of course, some sound effects. And these are so easy to use. Let me show you an example of a text box here. I like using the up one here, and you'll see the animation plays very briefly. And all you have to do is choose a point in the timeline you want this text to appear. And once you're there, just choose one of these presets. All you have to do is double click. And just like that, Premiere Composer will add something to your sequence. And you'll see here when we press play, there's the animation. Now all you have to do here is go to transform, and you can customize its position, left, up, down. I'm gonna reset. You can adjust its size and more, such as rotation and even skew. But really we're just gonna change this to say, be creative, and you'll see it automatically populates, and you can do all the normal text customization here, like font, which I usually use railway, all caps, bold, all these things, which is perfect and awesome. And of course, if we wanted to change the background color, we can here is the container. And let's say we wanted this red or something. Now we have a red one, and we'll change the text to something more visible like white here. And boom, just like that, within a few clicks, you can see what our animation looks like now. All without having to mess with any keyframes or any complicated effects controls and layering that on this text layer. And to show you how easy it is to even do transitions, when you do go between two clips, make sure your playhead is between them. I use the arrow keys to get precise, specifically the up or down arrow key. And then when we go to the transitions pack here, you open that, and you have a ton of options. Pan, which you can even choose the direction of, whether it goes left, comes from the bottom, comes from the right. You have your zoom outs, which is very popular, zoom ins as well. I like using those. Shake distortion, which is a cool like music video one, I would say. And my most popular one, which is light leak. And once again, make sure your playhead's between the two clips. Double click light leak. And Premiere Composer just adds it right in, and we can play that so you can get a look at what it looks like. It's just that easy. And you can take this further really by selecting the adjustment layer, and you can even change the color of the lens flare to your liking. And let me just show you one more cool thing you can do with Premiere Composer, and that's actually using the shape elements. You can do certain arrows. You can have certain paths that like circle something, which is super useful for tutorials like this. You even have something like fireworks, which I sometimes do in some celebratory moments. And this rectangular animation that I also use for highlighting things sometimes. Let me show you the circle one really quick. Let's say I wanted to add a circle to his head. I'll just choose one of these here. Move the playhead over to where the animation sort of ends, which is towards the middle. We're gonna change this color to something visible like red. And now we can move it. I like using the motion parameters here. Seems a lot easier. And that's it. Now, if we go back and start and check our animation, we have a nice little circular animation that's supposed to draw the viewer's attention to what we want them to see. All right, so that's enough of Mr. Horse. Let's move on to my second favorite plugin, which is actually gonna be FireCut. So FireCut uses a lot of AI to automatically do tasks for you in the editing process. As you can see in this list, you already have removed silences, remove filler words, add zooms, add YouTube chapters, remove repetitive words, a multi-track feature, and some captions and B-roll stuff. Sincerely, since Adobe Premiere Pro added the remove silences and filler words, I don't really use that, but my favorite way to use this app is for podcast editing using the multi-track feature. So let me show you how that works. So if we go to multi-track here, we'll select it, and we can select our speakers in this case. And as you can see in this timeline, I have two speakers. The bottom one, his name, we'll call him host. And then on the second layer, I have guest. And if you had any more, you can use this plus sign to add them. But now we go to the video tracks and we just make sure they match. So video one is to the host. Video two is to the guest. And if I did have a third angle with the host and the guest, I would add that to video track three and it would probably be the track on top here. But with all that done, now I just choose, do I want the full sequence done with this? Yes. And we're gonna hit analyze. And now what FireCut's doing is it's gonna be processing and analyzing the clips to see where someone's speaking and when someone's not speaking. And we'll come back when it's done. All right, so you see analyzing does take a little bit of time. I'll share the time that it took for this specific clip now. But once it's all done, you can see that you get this new menu and cutaways, since we don't have a third angle, I'm gonna have to turn off because that's essentially what that would help control. And then you have the option to boost speakers, which simply means that they'll sort of add a signal to whoever's speaking and suppress the other side, just so that there's no so much overlap, because sometimes people speak that way and they interrupt each other. And then we have the option to either disable the clips that where this person is not speaking, or to actually just delete them from the timeline. I have found it much more useful to have disable just so that you still have access to the clips, as you'll see here shortly. So let's just press go and see how fast it does this. This will not be sped up. And literally, as you saw, within that must have been 10 seconds or less, all the cuts are made on the timeline. And we'll see, we have our first speaker. And then once it gets to the next cut here, it cuts to the other speaker right on cue. You can even see on the audio track how precise it is. It is such a lifesaver. And look, at just essentially edited this whole podcast for me. And now I can spend my time focusing on actually choosing the right clips that I can cut down into the social media edits that I do for this client. So that's how I use FireCut. As mentioned, there are a bunch of other features. I used to try using the Find B-roll and Create Highlights, but it hasn't been as successful. Everything else about it otherwise I don't get to use very often, just because Adobe has added these features natively to the app. All right, moving into my absolute favorite plugin, we're gonna be talking about Premiere Gal's Toolkit for Adobe Premiere Pro. So you'll see here on the right-hand side, it's not actually called Premiere Gal Toolkit. Instead, it uses Atom X, and within that, it has the toolkit. There are a ton of things here to dive into. I will not be able to cover all of them here, but I will show you some of my favorite effects. So number one, I love the social media YouTube banners from this toolkit. I use this one all the time, and in fact, I've already pre-rendered it and saved it onto my hard drive, so I don't have to render it again. But this one was so awesome, it's so smooth. Let me show you how this one looks. So once again, like all the other plugins, just make sure your playhead's on the part of the scene where you want to add this effect. And then you just double click. You can see the animation, how it looks, but we can customize it as you see. So you can customize it either in the Atom X here, which there's a little customizer button here. But what I like to do is actually go to the essential graphics and then go to the edit tab with the actual effect selected. And you'll see that you have full control of everything here. So let's start by replacing the media. So you need your photo here. I should upload that. And all you do now is with your uploaded photo, just drag and drop it into this section. And now you'll see it populates and the graphic is updated immediately, so you know exactly if it looks correct. And let's say I want to scale this up, I would make this maybe 25%. And yeah, that looks a little more better. And now we can customize the text as well. So instead of saying Premiere Gal, it would be my YouTube channel name, which is Bruno Pozo for real. You can change the font once again, which I will, to my font. And I'll change this to filmmaker, photographer, And normally I leave the subscribe text as is because it's perfect. Subscribe to subscribed. And we could even customize if this hand animation cursor shows up at all. So we can turn it off here and we'll see that it still plays, but without the cursor animation present. And then of course you can change the size of this, the width of the box, all that good stuff. And just like that, I have such a smooth and clean animation. All right, so I'm gonna take out this subscribe so we don't lag for the rest of this edit. And now let me show you my favorite text animation that I use from Premiere Gal. So we're gonna open to Premiere Gal. We'll scroll down to text animation. And it's actually under Elastic. And you'll see I already have them favorited. I like the first one a lot. So I'll double click now. And now we just scroll in the timeline towards the center because that's typically where you'll be able to see the text. I'm gonna select the text and then go to Essential Graphics to edit it. And now I'm gonna change this to say something like, and then you can do all the typical text editing. So I'm gonna add my font here. I really like editing this effect down here that says motion blur, turn that on. And then I like to add a drop shadow as well. And you see, as we did just a few clicks here, if we go to the start of this timeline, I'm about to put this on as low as possible so it won't stutter, but you'll see the animation looks great. All right, and now I'll show you how you can even do camera movement using Premiere Gal. So we'll go to the beginning of the next clip with the down arrow key. We'll go into Premiere Gal here, close text animation, and it should be in effects. If we scroll down effects, we should see camera movement. And we have a ton of options that are labeled. So there's fast zooming out, fast zooming in, and then slow versions of each of those. I personally really like the fast zoom outs for emphasis. So I'll do that now by double clicking. And you'll see the adjustment layer has been made on our timeline. And if we go full screen and play, you should see how this zoom out looks. And just like that, we have added a nice little touch of animation without doing any work on keyframes. And honestly, there are so many more effects and animations you can take advantage of in Premiere Gal's toolkit. And that's why it is my favorite one, because of just how versatile it is. It is truly like my one-stop shop for pretty much everything minus the AI editing that FireCut provides me. If you want to learn even more about how you can save time editing in Premiere Pro, check out this tutorial here where I teach you how to do exactly that using templates. Thank you all so much for watching all the way until the end. I appreciate every single one of you who do. If you have any questions about Adobe Premiere Pro, leave them in the comment section down below. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.